Issue 3, Your Fists of Fury. Men have cold hearts. Prince Heinrich, the Austrian oligarch, creates a big-chop bazaar from the city's orphans, but Spencer Birmingham, fiscal philanthropist and also secretly none other than The Fury, that Thane of Thwack, stumbles across the Chilling Child Circus and vows to help the oppressed orphans. Returning to his office, he is met by Professor Farenshine, the masterful meteorologist, who needs a benevolent benefactor to fund his weather-controlling machine. Our hero chooses to fund the deparented diminutives instead of the brilliant, bespectacled Boffin of the Barometric. The altered investor, Elvis Rockbottom Coburn, the miserly metier of money-grubbing, cuts corners cash-wise, crippling the kind climatologist's cantankerous contraption. The defective device becomes destructive, invoking terrible tornadoes in the city. Our poobah of POW leaps into action, and with one well-placed punch, destroys the doomed and damaged device. Pitiably, Professor Farenshine's forehead is pierced with particles of the machine's meteorological makeup and is rendered unconscious. Coburn, outraged at the destruction of his ill-funded investment, sets the downstairs crew on the Fury, where they are deftly defeated by the dauntless duelist. During the ferocious fracas, Professor Farenshine, filled with meteorological might and the need for rapid revenge, slinks away, turning the weather to high summer and slaughtering the wretched ringmaster Charlie Twitcher with his weather wizardry. He wins the orphans' hearts. He kidnaps Professor Lydia Frost, generator of gizmos, and the only person to know the Fury's true identity. The orphans, those mighty midget marauders intent on ransacking the city, capture Spencer Birmingham before he can transform into the Fury, and they take him to Farenshine's secret powerhouse headquarters. All seems lost, but Professor Lydia Frost slips a certain red glove to Spencer, causing a startling transformation into the Fury. Beset by the orphans, but unwilling to cudgel children, the Fury utilizes Lydia Frost's latest invention to shrink himself down to orphan size. During the pint-sized performance of powerful pugilism, Professor Farenshine escapes to the roof. Spencer discards his Fury powers, intent on reasoning with Farenshine, but the mad meteorologist is too deeply disturbed to listen to loquacious litany. Spencer surrenders with a handshake, but perceptively pilfers the doctor's glove, returning him to furious power to purposely punch the perpetrator for the powerhouse power pits. The city is once again saved by the Fury.